They paid thousands to give up their U.S. citizenship. Now they want a refund. There was a lawsuit that was filed by many accidental Americans, follows a State Department announcement that it would lower the fee required to renounce citizenship. This just came out in the news just several days ago, and it's pretty big. It's I'll tell you more on how it's going to work here. The price of being a U.S. American who lives abroad is often an accent that sticks out. Jokes about culinary inferiority and sometimes even issues opening a bank account or buying a house. But for some former citizens, the price to renounce that status has been long and steep. Now, many of them want refunds, filing a class action lawsuit Wednesday to try to get their money back. It marks a new stage in a year-long battle about accidental Americans. These are U.S. citizens who neither live in the country nor have any sort of real ties to it, but must still pay taxes to Uncle Sam to reduce the cost that they face. Now, the $2,350 that a lady by the name of Rachel Heller paid to renounce her citizenship years ago was almost equivalent to her monthly salary. The State Department announced Monday it would be dropping the fee back to $450, the amount it used to charge until 2014. Now, Heller was a Netherlands resident and one of the lead plaintiffs in the lawsuit, and she wants a refund of the difference. And this is a big class action lawsuit, and they're also going to be going after and suing for the tax laws of being taxed on worldwide income based on citizenship. A lot of people have been paying literally, I mean, over the years, if you add them up together, it's millions and millions of dollars, and these people want it back. Anyway, it went on to talk about, it's like a divorce. Heller was talking about is one of 30,000 former U.S. citizens, according to the Accidental American Association, which is organizing the lawsuit and calling for change in the tax system. Unlike most citizens, the United States imposes a citizenship-based taxation system, irrespective of where a person lives or works. Also, folks, if you want to legally get around high income taxes or how to get a second passport as quick as 45 days, do three things. Hit the subscribe button at the right of your screen right here, and you get new videos automatically as they come out. And I would like to hear from you. If you got a question or comment, put it below and go to our website, www.citizenshipquickly.com, and just ask for some help. Now, she went on to say it was far more complicated for people living overseas, and the threat and fees if you did it wrong or left something off by mistake were so high that she said, I really paranoid about, you know, trying to do it herself. And she's this lady was 61 years old and told NBC News in a telephone interview that it was driving her nuts. So in 2015, the former teacher turned travel writer decided to that she couldn't keep spending. She spent $1,100 every year for an accountant to file her U.S. taxes and declare her entire personal life to a country that she had left in 1997. This happens to a lot of people. That some people have never ever been in the U.S. and they've had to file their taxes every year because they got based on citizenship. But she went to her nearest embassy in Amsterdam near the city that she had immigrated to for a brief but final visit that left her in tears as she gave away her U.S. passport. She said she felt like it was a divorce, but it was by somebody you love, but by someone who's not good for you. And she went on to say that she grew up in Connecticut and moved to the town of Groningen, Netherlands. And it was accidental Americans began coming to the attention of the U.S. tax authorities some decades ago. These are people, some of them that actually have never been to the U.S., but they're U.S. citizens, and they're having to file these taxes no matter where they live. In 2010, Congress enacted the Foreign Account Tax Compliance Act, also called FATCA, to crack down on tax evasion by Americans with financial assets abroad after a Swiss bank scandal showed U.S. taxpayers hid millions of dollars overseas. The law requires foreign banks to report on financial assets and accounts held by U.S. citizens to the IRS. And as a result, many of the Americans learned that they may owe taxes in the U.S. for services they've never received after getting contacted by banks in countries where they live and are you know, trying to be tax compliant. And, you know, the State Department started imposing a fee for Americans to renounce their citizenship in 2010, and then in 2014, it was increased from $450 to $2,350. Now, listen to this. It's one of the highest in the world, citing a dramatic increase in applications that require more resources. They were just using this as an excuse to try to keep people from relinquishing. But the proposed reversal of $450 was in line with the cost of other services provided abroad. It said in a Federal Register notice on Monday. Now, the State Department did not immediately comment on the lawsuit, but rather than resolving the causes of what leads individuals to renounce American nationality, which FATCA law and citizenship-based taxation, the State Department has preferred to put up barriers to limit the constant increase in renunciation requests. And this was brought out by Fabian Lahegri, who's president of the Accidental Americans Association. But it's not just the taxes that have forced an increasing number of Americans to quit their citizenship, including Heller's 25-year-old son. A burden came about, and that was it was becoming clear that the banks were going to make things more and more difficult for her. And she noticed this, and she said that some banks around the world would refuse services such as opening an account, home loans would become tougher, and the paperwork the diaspora had to endure skyrocketed. Experts say that this was because the cost of complying with FATCA ultimately fell on the banks, which became increasingly reluctant to serve Americans. Now, any mistake while filing the required forms could come with fines amount to thousands of dollars, meaning that having dedicated accounts just for American taxes was more and more necessary. Now, for a lot of Americans, the hassle of being an American from a day-to-day financial being, just not worth it. She went on and talked about it. Just you've got interest penalties and even criminal penalties. A tax lawyer by the name of David Lesperance wrote in this article. And it went on to say that you've got full U.S. tax liability, income, gift, and estate taxes. And it's just it's too much work for people that don't even live in the U.S. and they're not even participating in the U.S. Things to do there. You know, but amid these hurdles, a record number of U.S. citizens have chosen to become expatriates. Now, the IRS data showed that more than 1,300 people renounced their U.S. citizenship between January and June just of this year. And the actual cost could balloon up to thousands, he said, as many struggle to even get an appointment with an embassy in the country they live in or forced to travel to other countries. Many who finally go through the process do so reluctantly. Now, Esther Jenke, also completing her master's degree in Nebraska when she met a German husband in 1994. Together, they decided to move to Hamburg, Germany the same year. But it wasn't until 2017 that she became fully aware of her tax obligations. She had finally already had started thinking about retirement plans, but her nationality got in the way. It was extremely difficult, she mentioned, because the banks didn't want her as an American client. Many of them refused to take her. So she said that, she put all her assets in her husband's name. This type of desperation that people go through. The house they bought after saving up for years could be taxed if they sold it. And, she just felt like she was really angry over this, over her own country. It's forcing her to give up her own citizenship just to have a financially sound retirement. And she said that she ultimately renounced her citizenship in 2018 at the Frankfurt Embassy. And she said that she felt more free now and can focus more on life in Germany without the U.S. hanging over her head. Isn't that something? Germany's got incredibly high taxes, even higher than the U.S. But the fact is the U.S. is actually more belligerent in following you around because Germany at least doesn't tax you on your worldwide income based on your citizenship. They do based on residency. Anyway, folks, if you want to learn more on this, go to our website, www.citizenshipquickly.com. If you want to legally get around high income taxes or how to get a second passport as quick as 4 to 8 months. And I would like to hear from you. If you got a question or comment, put it below. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button right on your screen right here. You'll get new videos automatically as they come out. And I look forward to talking to you on the next video. Take care.